presentation will be about improving students' experimental competencies using simultaneous lessons in classes and in assessments. And I will describe an experiment that was conducted at the School of Engineering at Porto. I will start with a brief introduction to contextualize what I will present afterwards. Then I will describe the implementation design. After that, I will talk a little bit about the data analysis and discussion of the results. And finally, I will present our preliminary conclusions of this study and what we can do afterwards to improve and implement several of the things that we already see that it could change. As you all know, in the engineers, the experimental work is very important. Traditionally, this work was conducted in laboratories, but with the increase of the number of students and the economical restraints, these physical resources are no longer enough. So, in the last decades, scientists started developing computer simulations and remote labs, and somehow these tools bridge a little bit that gap. So what we are doing here in this experiment is using, as well as traditional resources, we are also using computer simulations and remote labs. They have the advantage that students can do the experiment as many times as they want, from various places, for instance, from their home, without being subject to the eyes of the others, and that way they can improve their autonomous work and that those competencies. In literature, these tools have been used for several years now. They prove to be effective in students' learning gains. And when you use several resources, you have to be aware that each method allows developing different competencies. So you have to have some care to use the several resources. And you have to have some harmony between them. And as you provide the resources used for teaching, you can reach more students because each of us has a different way of learning. And although that there are some works about the use of these resources in engineer, the gains that students have achieved are still very unstudied. So this experiment was done in an electricity course in the first year of the second semester of a three-year degree in automotive engineering. In this course, it were enrolled 79 students. This course has the normal duration of 15 weeks, but these resources were implemented for the first 6 weeks of the semester, and after that, in the seventh week, students were evaluated using all resources. This course has 1 hour recitation class per week, 1 hour calculus practice, followed immediately by 1 hour of laboratory classes. So it's 3 hours of contact per week. In these classes, we try to use all these resources. So here you can see an example of a circuit that the students have to assemble and have to use in the what we call PL classes, in the laboratory classes. So what they do? They use multimeters to measure voltage and electrical currents, and then they perform some basic calculus using the electricity laws to calculate other variables. Here you can see an example of the circuit simulator that they used. This simulator was used in theoretical classes for immediately visualizing circuit variables as the teacher explained the concepts, and was also used in the laboratory classes. So they performed the experiment, as shown in the previous slides, and then they could use the simulator to compare the results. And apart from the use in classes, students were able to use these resources how many times they wanted via Moodle. So each student has individual credentials to enter Moodle, so they could use it from home or wherever they wanted. And we could track the number of times that they used both remote labs and a simulator and all the other resources that were available in Moodle.
Here is an example of a remote lab, which is called VISIM. It was used both in theoretical classes to identify the hands-on perceptor, and it was used in the PL classes, sometimes to compare the results between the hands-on laboratory and the results obtained both as the simulator and as the remote. After the 6 weeks of this experiment, the students were submitted to an individual lab assignment which would target all the competencies and use all the resources that were using previously in the classes. There were the 24 different test versions because the students were enrolled in 3 PL classes during several days of the week. Here you can see an example of these tests. And the test consisted of the analysis of these 2 circuits. In the first circuit, they had to do calculus work, simulation and remote lab, and then they had to compare the results. And the second circuit, they had to use hands-on laboratory, so perform the experimental and simulation. So, to compare students' perception of learning and their opinions on the different learning and teaching results with their academic resources, with their academic results, we recorded several types of tests. First, we decided to analyze the test assignment results, and we analyzed it by component, the calculus, simulation, remote, and the hands-on, and then the overall results for all students. Students were also submitted to a questionnaire, and that questionnaire was delivered in a single sheet of paper at the beginning of the PL class, and it consisted of 3 parts. The questionnaire was anonymous. The first part concerned about learning environments. The student had to realize the type of classes, activities that he had done in a Likert scale from 1 to 5. The second part consisted about the type of study, and they had also to serialize in a scale from 1 to 5 the type of study that affects their learning in terms of interaction with the others. And the third part of the questionnaire was just to split 100% learning responsibility from themselves, teachers, colleagues, and other factors. And at the end of the questionnaire, that was an open question, where we asked the students to say which were the things that helped or hindered their study and learning, and explain why. We also recorded the teacher's perception of the didactic intervention and students' learning in a semi-directive interview. And now I'm going to present the results with all these tools. So, considering the test results, as you can see at the graphic, the students show better results at simulation, and where they have more difficulties, it is at the remote lab. The test was compulsory, mandatory, All the students had to perform it. But not all of them performed it, some didn't go. But 83% of the students attended the test. And as you can see in the graphic, the overall result was good. They had good results in this lab assignment. Then we decided to see if it was any correlation between the students that attended most of the classes with the results that they had at the final test. And we could see that the most attending students performed better, and that this was more relevant at the remote laboratory. But the correlation is not very good. Coefficient, the correlation coefficient was low. As we could track the number of times that the students use as well as the remote laboratory as the simulator via Moodle, we decided to see if it was any correlation between the number of assets in each typical component and the final result that they had. And as this graphic can show you, there is a tendency that students that assess it more have better grades, but this correlation is also not so good. Considering the questionnaire, And considering the first part, the different learning environments importance, we can see that students find that the best learning environment is hands-on, followed immediately by campus classes. Remote lab, simulation and lecture and, were not considered so interesting, but they don't have many differences in comparison between each other. Considering the type of study, they consider that the type of study that is better for them, considering in terms of interaction with the others, is in class or with the help of the teacher. We were quite surprised with the classification that they put in the study with the computer. As you can see here, it's the one that they consider is less important. And as students are always using computer tools and all those kind of tools, we thought that we had a better classification here. This weak classification that they put in the computer is then again in the questionnaire they refer that they don't consider the environment very good because they feel the computer is more a distractor than a helper. They start to use the computer for doing something about the study and then they are doing so many things that they get distracted and they don't think it's very helpful. About the learning responsibility distribution, as you can see, they consider that they are responsible for 47% of their learning, but the teacher is still quite responsible with 34% of the learning. About the open question that we made at the end of the questionnaire, and where they had to say which were the things that helped them the most or hindered their study. In the graphic from the left, you can see that they put more factors that help them in the hands-on and in the campus classes. And they refer factors as at hands-on that they can practice and do the things themselves and that helps them. That in the campus classes, doing the calculations is good because they understand how you can solve problems that then at the exam you are going to be submitted to. And in the right graphic, they do identify the number of factors in relation to each type of study. And you can see that the number of factors they point to the professor are the ones that have more factors. And the colleagues and autonomous work are followed immediately by this one. Finally, we have recorded the teacher perception in a semi-directed interview. The teacher has about 20 years experience in this course. And about the didactic approach, he says that the use of various tools is very important because it helps students adapt the complexity of practical problems in the future. And he says also that remote lab is very useful and helps to compensate the large number of students involved in each PL class. And in each class, the students were divided by groups, and these groups don't have two students, but four or five. So it's a large group. So it's not so good because students cannot, all of them, perform an experiment. And the remote lab somehow compensates that problem. And also the problem that they have very few time of laboratory classes, just 1 hour per week. About students learning, he says that this helps students developing basic knowledge and competencies about electricity, which was the main objective of the course. Conclusions about this work. We could see that hands-on and calculus classes were the preferred learning environments for students. Still, these were not the environments where they performed better. They performed better, as you remember from the graphic, and at simulation. They were much more at ease with simulation environments than with a remote lab. Remote lab, they think it was one of the ones which they had more difficulties. they think that Easy, which was the remote lab that they used, was felt as an extra obstacle the youth had to endure. It had lots, they had lots of difficulties to overcome this platform, but some students say that after doing this initial effort to overcome these difficulties, then they understand how remote lab worked, and then that tool was very useful. But still lots of students couldn't pass this initial obstacle. Students' distribution of the learning responsibilities shows that students are still very dependent on what their teacher does and how he orients his work. And students in general are more involved and participative in the proposal task, and they achieve better school results when compared to the previous years, which was one of the things that is good in this study. We also concluded by the questionnaire, by the opinion of students, that we could change some things to improve the design of the course. So we think that we can spend less time in calculus classes because they feel quite at ease with that kind of calculus. We can spend less time in introducing the simulator because the first PL class was used to introduce all the devices, and they find that the simulator is quite easy, so you should not spend so many time introducing it. And at the laboratory, at hands-on, they think, and it's true, that we have to have better and more material available. The groups should be smaller. There should be computers in every branch so they can compare immediately the results obtained by the several resources. And that is more difficult. There should have more time in class. And finally, we think that the key to increase students' score results and competence is finding the right balance between all these components. Thank you.